Good morning, a very happy and cheerful morning to all my children. So today we are going to continue with our subject English grammar, and we are going to start a new chapter, and that is chapter number 16, present continuous tense. Present continuous tense. In our previous semester we have discussed about what is simple present tense, okay? And in this semester, our new chapter, chapter number 16, I want all of you to open the page number in your textbook 73 and present continuous tense, okay? So let's first check out what is present continuous tense by first checking out the examples, okay? So let's read the sentences first. Present continuous tense. First example we have, read these sentences. I am watching television. They are reading in the library. Swati is working on the computer. Okay, so we have all the verbs in ing forms. That is present continuous tense. That is, it is going on. Okay, so see in the textbook also we have those examples. I am watching television. Okay, so here we have, just a minute, yeah, here we have, I am watching television, they are reading in the library, Swati is working, which means the current action is in process. Okay, so the words printed in bold are verbs. And they are in the present continuous tense. They tell us about actions which are still going on. Example, I'm watching, I'm reading, he's working. Okay? So just analyze the definition, dear children. The present continuous tense tells us about actions that are going on at the time of speaking. Okay, so when you are speaking, when you are saying the sentence, the action is going on. So we call it as present continuous tense. Okay, and how we are going to find it out? We are going to find it out when they are in the form of ing. Okay, they are in the ing form of the verb. So let's read the example. See, these were the three examples that we had. Okay, and they were in the ing form of the word. Always remember that when we say I am walking, okay, he, she, or it is walking, any singular subject in the third person, okay, when you're having any singular subject in the third person, we, you, they are walking. Okay, so here we find that there are plural. Okay, so we have any plural subject. So always remember, we are writing the ing form in the verbs in this way. Okay, see here they have given you the examples. Verbs like sleep. Sleep plus ing forms sleeping. Walk plus ing, walking. Eat plus ing, eating. Okay, so these are all present continuous tense. Easy? You get it? Alright, very good. Moving towards the next one. Yes, over here. Now this you have to understand. Okay, just underline that. When a word ends in E, okay, we omit the E and add ing. See, here you have one example, that is rice. So, rise plus ing is rising. Write plus ing Double the last letter. So R U N N I N G. Okay, N I N G. Running. Hit. Hitting. Shut. Shutting. Okay. So here you have. You are going to double the last letter. Okay. The next one. When verbs end in I-E. Like for example, die, die, lie. Then what happens? You are going to change the I-E to Y. So die, dying. D-Y-I-N-G, dying. Die, dying. Lie, lying. Okay, getting the difference? If you have I-E, you are going to change it into Y. And if you are having certain letters, okay, then you are going to double the last letter. And if you are having E at the end, then you are going to omit. That means you are going to skip the E and then add ING. Okay, so always remember, we have these types when we are changing the word into ING form. Okay? Alright, shall we solve the first exercise part? Alright? Okay, write down the ING form of the following verbs. Alright? Okay, we'll solve the first five and the remaining I'll ask you to do as you're looking. Okay? So let's solve the first one. Sent. Sent. Sending. You're going to add ING at the end. Write. What we are supposed to do? We are going to skip E. So, W-R-I-T-I-N-G. Writing. Okay, we are going to omit E. Carry. So, we are going to add I-N-G. That is carrying. Next. Watch. Add I-N-G. Watching. And last. Blue. G, blowing. Easy? Yes? Okay? So you have to complete the remaining exercise part now. Okay? So that is your task. So dear children, I hope you understood how we are going to add ING forms. Okay? What are the rules? Which are the letters that we are going to skip? Which are the letters that we are going to omit? Or how we are going to add ING at the end of certain verbs? Okay? So, see you soon for the next video. Till then,